So you're looking to build your flight simulator. I hope this video helps you out in making a decision on what kind of equipment to buy and how to set it up. So we'll go over it real quick. I am running this off of my Mac Mini M1, and my screen is a 42-inch Vizio television I just have sitting there, and I have the Logitech flight simulator set up. I will put a link in the description in the comments to this equipment here, so you can pick it up on Amazon if you want. I'll also put a link to the powered USB that I have all of the Logitech Yoke and Rudders and everything running off of. So this plugs into the wall and this plugs into the computer. You need this. This helps so you don't have any kind of wacky stuff going on with your equipment. So what I have here, I have the X-Plane. Whenever I load X-Plane on this computer, it automatically shoots it over to this TV and has it set up. And I've already got it in an in-flight here so we can show. And I just have a kitchen chair that I pull up here. If you watched any of my older videos, you know that I used to have it set up on these curved screens. I used to have two curved screens, and I went to one curved screen. And then I moved it over here on this little desk I had laying around so I could work on my computer and just leave my flight simulator set up all the time. And I'm not rigging it down all the time when I have to work on the computer or when I want to run this flight simulator. So let's go over some of this stuff over here, how I have it set up. So this yoke, it's got every button you need. Okay, there's buttons on this back. There's a scroll bar on the back. It moves up and down, in and out. I really never do anything with these three buttons, but you just come in here and it was all plug and play. I do have the Logitech Options Plus app, which I don't know if that helps, but I have it. And I plugged it in and it just flipping worked, okay? So you just come up here to your menu, click on it, and here we are at the joystick, okay? So we're joystick, and you just scroll through here. If something's set up, not set up where you want it, you just scroll through here and you can change it to whatever you want it to be. It goes through the quadrants, it goes through everything, okay? So that's what I did. You have a keyboard. If you want to play with a keyboard, which I have one here, which I only use if I need it. I mostly have everything set up here that I need, so I don't have to use the keyboard. But when I used to use the keyboard a lot, I made this little stand. I 3D printed it to hold my keyboard up here. And there's things you can use the keyboard for, like getting rid of the yokes. You push the Y, you see that? You push the Y, it goes away. So that's what I have that for, but I don't really use that. So we'll just set it over here off the side. I just want to show it. And I have my mouse set up over here. So my mouse is going to run everything that I need. All right, so we can come in here. We go to a new flight. We got a Cessna Skyhawk here. And we'll just take off from this Kauai River, whatever it is, Lodge. And let's do a 3 nautical mile approach and start the flight. All right, now it hasn't started paused. I have the pause button as the button on the back of this yoke. So there, I've unpaused it. You just gotta give this little flick because it's trying to land on this runway right here. You can zoom in there, you can see, trying to land right there, but we're not gonna land. We're just gonna play around here. So if I zoom out a little bit, you can see, I mean, the response is pretty good. It's not bad. You probably set it up where it responds a little bit better, but it responds pretty good. And you have your rudder pedals, they respond. All right, and going back to the keyboard here, I like this keyboard. The main thing I use on the keyboard is these up and down buttons, because I can move up where I'm further up in the cockpit, okay? And then I can zoom right here. You can move around, that's not the zoom. The zoom is over here. I'm crazy. See, you can zoom in and out here with this button. All right, and then you come back over here. You can toggle around, you can look. Let's straighten her out before we crash. You can look all the way around in the cockpit with that. And then you've got it all wonky. You can just come over and push W and puts you right back to the middle. So as we're right back to the middle, I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. And then I'm gonna frame it up just a little bit here. You can see out the window, we really can't see the gauges, but you can see out the window. And there's a scroll wheel on the back of this side where you can scroll to that side. You can scroll to that side and it clicks in the middle. So it clicks this way, clicks that way, clicks in the middle. Pretty slick. So here we are flying here. Now, you could change all these buttons in those settings we just looked at. So what I do, I made a little post-it note right here that tells me what this stuff does, what I have it changed to. And I also have a post-it note here to tell me what these buttons do. So you have these buttons, it looks like three, but it's six buttons, and you can make them do whatever you want. So to be more realistic, I've taken things off of the keyboard and put them into these buttons. Like this middle button here is my flaps up and down. So flaps down right here, flaps up here. This one resets the flight. It really helps if it tries to freeze up or you crash, you can just push that button and it just resets the flight real quick and it puts you right back at the start. So this is right back where we started, just reset it, right? All right, and then you can see that's the top one. The bottom one is to take your brakes on and off. And the one over here on the right is to quit. So I push that button, it does my brakes when I'm on the runway so I can go. And it works out pretty good. It's pretty slick. Like I said, this is a 42-inch Vizio TV I had. I just rigged it up over here and it worked just fine. And the speakers are just the Vizio speakers that came with the TV, the internal speakers. But I mean, we really enjoy playing with this. It's a lot of fun. And I think you would have a lot of fun if you ended up getting it. I mean, I haven't had any other ones, so I can't say, oh, the other ones are better, but I imagine there are some better quality ones, but for the money, this thing gets you playing, gets you flying. I really like it. Like I said, I'll put a link to it in the description on Amazon. You can go look at it yourself and see if it's something you think you might want to get. I mean, it comes as an entire kit. You don't have to, you know, you don't have to buy separate things. I see a lot of people, they'll have like a honeycomb yoke, and then they'll still have the Logitech rudder pedals. But this is a kit. And it all comes together and it all works together. And I hear people having issues with the Mac. I don't know, on the box of mine, it says it's compatible with Mac. So maybe you need to look for that, you know? So, well, mine works just fine. I haven't had any issues with it. I have other Logitech stuff. This is Logitech mouse. I don't have any issues with it either. So that's all I have for this video. I hope you like this video. If you like it, you know, give me a thumbs up and don't forget.